welcome to the Louisiana Renaissance Festival in Hammond. I'm Tamika Lee.
And I'm LBJ. And you know, so much to see here, so much to do. But one of the places we love coming is to the blacksmith shop. Larry House joins us. Hello, Larry.
Hello, good to see you.
Good to see you too. And blacksmithing goes back centuries and important to any village.
The blacksmith is the individual in the village that provides them with anything they needed that would have been made from metal. We do everything from the door pulls for the and the locks for the boxes, the hinges of the doors, anything that was made of metal had to come from a blacksmith. Well, the metal, when in order for us to work it, it has to be around 2,000 degrees Fahrenheit. To get that, we either burn charcoal or coal, and that brings the metal up to that temperature. And we have to stop working on it and get it back into the fire before it's by 1,000 degrees. So it's always hot while we're working it, very hot, and therefore that's a danger.
How does one become a blacksmith? You know what I mean? Like, can I become a blacksmith?
Only if you want to, but exactly true. Anyone can learn this art form. There's many, many blacksmiths around the country today. Even though they say it's a dying art, it's not true. It's growing.
Oh, wow. It seems magical of sorts, LBJ. Speaking of magical, Bill Wood is taking us to a Dark Ages magic show.
Is going to pass through solid steel like a ghost through a castle wall.
He's a magician who looks like a leprechaun. A 6'4", 275-pound, blue-eyed, red-bearded, former high school football player, offensive lineman of a leprechaun.
You're sort of hard to miss out here among the pine trees somewhere between the 14th and 17th centuries, which is where I think we are.
Indeed, that is where we are, and that is by design. I made a point of being bright and visible so that people can see me from a long way off. I don't want them to miss nothing.
I don't think we'll miss anything.
I'll do my best to make sure you see it all. It's confusing because I'm holding two equal lengths of rope.
He's a leprechaun on the loose at the Louisiana Renaissance Festival. His name is Connor O'Carrick.
Only one piece of rope is confusing, right?
Despite his well-developed Irish accent, Connor was born and raised in New Orleans. Before he became a wizard with a bag of tricks, he was a musician.
This only works because my hat is deeper.
And before that, you actually studied mechanical engineering?
Yes, sir. About 2.5 years. I was going where I thought the money was, and there was good money, but I realized while I was doing it, I was much more passionate about being a performer. It's better to follow your own dreams, and look at where we are now. All four of these rings are identical. That's right, all four of these, especially this one.
Once upon a time, Connor O'Carrick studied to be a mechanical engineer, but he made the idea for that career disappear.
See, they're all identical, especially that one. I'm going to take the last one.
Just like he'll make your troubles vanish for a moment in the middle of the Renaissance.
That is where the ends go back on to the rope.
Bill Wood, WGNO News.
Thank you. I thought it was impressive, too, but who are we among so many people?
Favorite thing is costuming. I make my own things. I like to show it off.
I would have to say it's dressing up and being able to be like what you want to be.
Probably just the different interactions I get or experiences.
I had to come for the Vikings weekend, absolutely. And to see everybody all dressed up, I love it.
I think the architecture in the buildings, the way they're uniquely built and the unique costumes.
Probably the jousting. That was really cool.
I would really have to say the jousting.
It's something you don't see. Like you see it in movies and TV shows, but you never get to see that in person. You don't think it's acting. Like when you watch it, the horses are actually running at each other. And they're actually like, they got their jousting sticks down. They're hitting each other. It's pretty cool.
You are able to be your own person. It's a way to also get away and just have fun with other people and hang out.
I like the people because they are dressed absolutely amazing and they all look so beautiful.
Coming up, we'll take a taste of the most coveted item at the fest, the turkey leg.
Thank you. the food that I got was the hearty vegetable soup in a bread bowl, but I would say my favorite is probably the cinnamon donuts.
I'm torn between the turkey leg and the Jester chips.
My favorite food at the best is fried Oreos. I like Oreos, that's it.
Probably the Jester chips.
Get the chicken on a stick and it's pretty good.
Definitely the turkey legs. Have you seen them? They're huge and they taste really, really good.
Which one should I talk it to? Well seasoned, warm.
I don't eat beef. I don't eat no beef, sorry.
Scotch egg is a definite. I can't not get a Scotch egg. First thing I do when I come in the gate, go for the Scotch egg.
Just like hard-boiled eggs wrapped in sausage and fried.
My favorite food here at the festival probably has to be the cheesecake on a stick.
Cheesecake on a stick dipped in chocolate.
My favorite food has to be the wood-fired pizza here because, well, they make it with fire, first of all.
I haven't had a bad food here.
And if you don't have cash here at Louisiana Renaissance Festival, well, no worries. The Antique Teller Merchant, the ATM is here. Tell us your name.
It's Garrett.
Hey, Garrett, so all of the ATMs have people in them here.
Yeah, very personal touch in the ATMs.
Well, you would need it if you were Stephanie Oswald. She is getting a turkey leg. Stephanie?
Welcome to All By here at the Louisiana Renaissance Festival.
Where the menu is medieval and massive.
Yes, indeed. When it comes to food at the Louisiana Ren Fest, there are so many delicious options. But if you want to go the traditional route, you've got to try the turkey legs.
The steam, the smoke, the delicious things. This is why everyone's here.
I just got in probably 5 minutes ago, and this was my first stop. So, good way to start out the day. It kind of puts you in the feel of the Ren Fest and everything.
One by one, they come out of the cooler. But they're anything but cool. Eating them can even be romantic.
Ballpark, you have any idea how many of these you sell in a weekend?
So we sell about 15 cases per store. So probably about like over 1,000 at least, like per weekend, per day probably. So it's super popular here.
No one knows the exact number, but it wouldn't be RenFest without these hearty, handheld meals.
It's definitely a staple. People come back every year for it. We have a lot of other items too, but this is the one thing that people keep returning for.
I mean, it's just a primal thing. Come to a RenFest and just gotta eat some meat.
You barely have any left.
Yeah, it's just bone now.
How many of these are you gonna have over the course of the day?
I might try something else, but maybe a second. You never know. Maybe I'll double fist them.
Some say it's the hickory smoked chips that make the difference. For $13 a pop, try one for yourself.
It's like Thanksgiving, but better. People always look at it and they don't expect it to be as big as it is. Like, they hear about the turkey legs, and then when you actually get one, you see it and you're like walking around and it's just giant. Like, it's bigger than your microphone.
It is, guys. Hey, check this out. She is right. It is bigger than the microphone.
Stephanie Oswald, WGNO News.
Barrel rides. That looks like a lot of fun for them. Coming up after the break, we take you to one of the most popular attractions here at the Renaissance Fest, the Jousting Arena.
Be safe, be fair, don't let the humans get you. They are dirty, nasty creatures.
You are watching WGNO on the road at the Renaissance Festival.
Welcome back to Louisiana Renaissance Festival. A whole lot to do here. Go ahead, Tamika. You can try to do your spear thing there. Yeah, I'm glad we're not depending on you to eat. You can also chuck hatchets and knives and all that here. But Jordan Lippincott is jousting. Well, she's covering the jousting.
So the type of jousting we do is full contact, full armor jousting. We joust for real. We're very well protected. But the lances we use are more medieval. They're just kind of a long cylinder, so they don't break as easily. We kind of get to hit each other with that force.
which is why Silas Holtz, also known as Sir Victor Thorne, spends a fortune on armor, which is no different than what knights in training did during the Renaissance.
So in the early Middle Ages, jousting kind of evolved out of a sort of free-for-all tournament that happened that was kind of a brutal set of games that would train young men to be knights and warriors, people of the upper class. You need a lot of money to be a knight. And then it kind of became a sport.
And once the knights are off their horses, the match isn't quite over yet.
And then sometimes we'll bookend that with some theatricality. We'll have a ground fight that is loosely choreographed, but things go wrong and we're in armor, so if a sword breaks or something, we kind of roll with it. You know, as long as it looks brutal and one person's standing at the end and one person is not, the audience is generally pretty happy.
Holt says his favorite part is the competition and, of course, victory over an opponent.
You're just on your horse, you stare right down that the end of the list, and you see someone, you see their little soulless visor holes in their helmet staring back at you, and you know that you're gonna come after them, and they're gonna come right at you, and the world just like shrinks down to that moment, and you just ride straight at that danger.
Jordan Lippincott, WGNO News.
Love it, love it, love it. Tell us your names.
I am the Foxy Bard.
And I'm Twig.
And we have a show right here at the Painted Badger where you can get booze.
All right. You can get booze. And you can also, so this is not a guitar.
This is not a guitar. This is a bazooki. Tis what happens when a mandolin grows up and becomes a real boy.
Holy cow. And that is a guitar.
It's a regular guitar. Well, it's got 12 strings, but other than that, it's a regular guitar.
Indeed.
Well, some of the great entertainment you can see here at the Louisiana Renaissance Fest. To meet there's others as well.
I know. Did you know that the bagpipes have been around since 1000 BC? Did y'all know this?
Indeed, absolutely. And all over the place, not just in Scotland. They've got them in Spain.
Well, speaking of bagpipes, we have someone who has bagpipe music over there. Wild Bill, right?
The Sound of Music sounds like the Louisiana Renaissance Festival is ready for a new day. If the Renaissance sunrise had a sound, I think it would sound like bagpipes.
There is something very spiritual and very moving about the sound of the bagpipes. I think that's why people have us play at events like funerals. It just helps them to feel all kinds of emotions.
It's a family affair for Steve Brownlee, his daughter Jillian, and wife Pam on drums. Their concert started one day at a parade. Steve was just standing on the street watching the bagpipe players go by. And he said to himself, and then to his wife, "You know what, honey? I could do that." You did it, but you were not exactly a teenager or a toddler when you started.
No, I was in my late 30s when I started, which is unusual for somebody my age to get to where I've gotten. It takes a lot of hard work. It can be done.
Dad taught daughter, and then mom picked up the drums. It's loud, bold, and patriotic. And a sound that's so soothing, Steve takes naps and falls asleep every night to the bagpipes. Sweet dreams. Bill Wood, WGNO News.
Welcome back to the Louisiana Renaissance Festival. And we told you, yeah, there's food. Yes, there's entertainment, but there's also shopping. Tell us your names.
I'm Lady Margaret Howard, the Duchess of Norfolk.
And you are?
General Edmund Percy.
Now, Lady Howard, how would one have dressed during the Renaissance?
Well, particularly if you are of higher station as we are, the word you're thinking for is opulence. More fabric, more accessories. Think bling, think shiny, and of course, do not forget a fantastic hat.
And I've got this incredible jacket on. Is this what one would have needed?
You would have perhaps need quite a few different jackets, one for dinner as well as another one for fighting or traveling or few jackets.
Well, this is a good start. Yeah, this is not the fighting jacket. This is the nice dinner jacket, and an awful lot of shopping here for you at the Louisiana Renaissance Festival.
This is pretty cool. So I like the view up here. That's for sure.
Festivals for 15 years, but my first time at the fair, I was 11, so it's been a little bit.
This is our first year at the Louisiana Ren Fest, but it's definitely going to be a recurring event.
I've been coming since high school, and it's, you know, gotten a whole lot bigger out here, and I love to see the progress that this place has made.
I've been coming since I was a kid, so probably 10 to 15 years, somewhere in that range. It's just a tradition. Every year we come, it's one of the coolest things.
And you can be anything you want here at the Louisiana Renaissance Festival. Tell us your names.
I'm Sky.
Hey, Sky, and you are?
I'm Jeremy.
And you're Castle Crashers. Tell us what that is, Sky.
It's a video game that was released early 2000s. It's kind of a cult classic.
Ah, yeah, everybody noticed you guys here. I understand you guys come a lot and that you are always dressing in something different.
Yeah, pretty much. We've come as Mandalorians that look kind of like Iron Man and War Machine. We've come as Robin Hood and Maid Marian. But this is everyone's favorite, so we keep dressing up as Castle Crashers now.
Well, they're here to crash the castle. Jeremy, Sky, thanks so much. Coming out to Louisiana Renaissance Festival.
I am from Philadelphia, Pennsylvania, but I travel all over the country performing and doing what I love.
I actually am from Thibodaux, Louisiana.
I'm from Lake Charles, Louisiana.
I am from Beaumont, about 3.5 hour drive.
I'm from London, England.
I'm actually not too far from here, from Franklinton, Louisiana, which is in Washington Parish.
I'm from Picayune, Mississippi, and what brings me this fest is because my sister brought me in 2017, so we've been coming ever since then.
From Jackson, Mississippi, me and my friends come down every year.
I came here last year, so this is my second ever fest.
I'm from South Carolina.
I'm from Flowood, Mississippi.
Yeah, we come here every year because it's always a blast.
I do. I really enjoy the atmosphere. It's so much fun. It's just a bunch of nerds hanging out.
There goes the queen with the Daily Queen's Parade. Watching over her kingdom is thirsty work.
Yeah, our Stephanie Oswald is currently at a brew tasting and taking us along.
Rows of glasses and buckets of beer, signs that a tasting is about to appear.
We have a beer tasting, a tea tasting, a mead tasting, a wine tasting, a rum tasting.
There are 7 different types of tastings in all, and whichever one you choose, it's not all about the drinks. You also get entertainment and an education.
We like our men like we like our drinks, and they like us as well.
What we do is we select 7 different beers for everyone to sample. We do a 3 to 4 ounce pour of each beer, and we talk about each one in turn. Some of them are local, some of them are from far afield.
Each toast brings a different taste.
Maybe they've never had a sour, or maybe they've never had a pale ale, or a stout. So we try to mix it up so they can try a little bit of everything, and maybe discover a new favorite.
Between pours, Sir Francis Drake pours out information.
Tasting is more than just swallowing the beer. We want to engage all 5 of our senses. The first sense is the sense of sight. So when you get your beer before you, take a moment, hold it up to the light, take a look at your beer.
Light to dark, each weekend has a different lineup of lagers.
Just for good measure, I'll throw in some dirty jokes and dirty toasts.
That means that we can be a little more rude.
Aye.
Beer was a staple in the diet of Renaissance England and all of Europe. At this time period, beers were actually weaker than the beers that we have now. Most beers back then were only 2 to 3% alcohol, as opposed to modern beers, which are around 5 or 6. So they could drink a lot more beer in the day without feeling the effects as much.
Even though you may feel as if you're in the past, remember, these brews are from the present.
So before you come to the beer tasting, I would recommend do not pregame. You do not need to do that. Do not worry.
Cheers to libations served with laughter.
Let's host!
Stephanie Oswald, WGNO News.
Well, thanks for joining us for all this fun.
Yep, you can visit the Louisiana Renaissance Festival through December 11th.
Bye.